All right, welcome back inside our Proactive Newsroom. And joining me now is Jim McDonald, the CEO of Kootenay Silver. And Jim, welcome back. Great to see you again.
Good to be back, Steve.
Yeah, so you've wrapped up your drill program going on at the Columba Project in Mexico, and you've got four more holes to tell us about. We'll get to those in just a second. But overall, this program has been very successful, especially when it comes to the D vein, which we've talked about before.
Yeah, it sure has. I mean, this is a 12-hole program. We finished the 12 holes. We hit in every single hole, 12 out of 12 on that vein on step outs, expanding the size of the vein. And we're getting continue to get excellent widths and excellent grades throughout. So it looks really exciting. Two more holes yet to come out of that.
Yeah. So tell us about these four holes today. More of the same, I guess, is the way to describe them.
Yeah, pretty much. I mean, this vein's been so predictable. We're hitting really good widths everywhere where predicted. So very nice, consistent vein. And three out of the four holes returned over half kilo numbers. The best hole being 145, where we had 6 meters of 435 gram per ton silver within a 22 meter interval of 174. So that really helps juice the whole interval up itself. And that one more thing about that particular hole, it is the easternmost hole that is below that key 1700 meter depth, meters above sea level. Because as a rule of thumb, that's where we start to see the best grades occur. So it leaves it wide open in that direction and to depth.
Yeah. Jim, I just want to sort of explain process here, just so everyone kind of understands what the next stages are, because as we've talked about in the past, you're getting towards a maiden resource, but there's still quite a bit of work that has to be done first. And the first part of it was this D vein that you wanted to work on, but then there's more that you have to do because of spacing of drill holes. And maybe you can kind of explain that to us as you get towards the main resource.
Yeah. Lots of drilling. That's the bottom line. We've got now numerous veins to drill off. D vein is the fattest and richest zone thus far. And so we need to systematically just keep stepping away until we find the edges of the mineralization there. And so it's going to become a more of a systematic program, the next one of step-by-step fences of drill holes, define what you have. And then when you're referring to infill holes, you need to get the drill spacing close enough so you can be confident on the predictability of the grade in between the holes. So there will be step out drilling to expand the size, and then you're going to require infill to get enough density to have confidence to be able to do a resource estimate.
Yeah, it makes a lot of sense. Well, it sounds like we're going to be talking a lot in 2024 and obviously this year as well, because you still have two more holes to report. So we look forward to our next conversation, my friend.
Yeah, I look forward to it as well. Thanks, Steve.
All right, there's Jim McDonald, the CEO of Kootenay Silver.